Sultan Jahan Begum. She was the last of the Begums who struggled to gain power due to her mother's long-time rule. Sultan Jahan conceived and implemented many groundbreaking administrative reforms, which today are considered a mandatory part of any welfare state, but which were unheard of even in a constitutional monarchy like Great Britain. Inspired by her predecessors, Sultan Jahan Begum became a reformer and established many educational institutions focusing on public instruction and female education. It is important to mention here that even though working under the overall Quranic sagacity and Islamic piety, the Begums of Bhopal were not at all fundamentalist. Realizing that Hindu girls were not coming to a school open for girls because of their religious sentiments, Sultan Jahan Begum opened a school called Birgisia Higher Secondary School, named after her daughter, exclusively for Hindu girls. Sultan Jahan Begum contributed heavily towards the emancipation of women in India. She became the founding chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University and the first Indian woman to become a chancellor of an Indian university, which came into existence in 1920. To promote independence among women, an art school was started in the year 1905 for widows and destitute women. In 1914, she became the president of All India Muslim Ladies Conference and founded the All India Ladies Association during 1918 as well. Apart from education, she also reformed taxation, the police, the army, the judiciary, health and sanitation. It is well known that Sultan Jahan Begum provided financial support for the preservation and conservation of the ancient Buddhist stupa at Sanchi. She also funded the archaeological museum that was built there in 1919. This museum was later renamed as Sanchi Museum. A true visionary, she wrote biographies and books on education and health. For example, Bachoon Ki Parvarish, The Story of a Pilgrimage to Hijaz, Tandurusti, Hidayat Timardari. The legacy of her 25-year rule entailed a cosmopolitan court and a largely merit-based bureaucracy. Sultan Jahan Begum was so deeply respected and loved by her subjects that they referred to her as Sarkar Amma. She fought and won almost a lost battle of succession for her youngest son by negotiating with the British in order to strategically remain in power and mold politics in the interest of her state. The period of the Begums of Bhopal ended when Sultan Jahan's son, Nawab Hamidullah Khan, took the crown. He was the last ruling Nawab and the state later merged with Madhya Pradesh in 1956. The last Nawab had three children and his second eldest daughter, Sajida Sultan, was married to Iftikhar Ali Khan, the eighth Nawab of the Pataudi family. They had a son, Manzoor Ali Khan Pataudi, the famous cricketer, who married the Indian actress and descendant of Rabindranath Tagore, Miss Sharmila Tagore. The royal dynasty of Bhopal thus is memorable for their achievements as women, particularly Muslim women in colonial India, and inspirational for every woman in the contemporary India. Thank you very much for watching.
Please like, share and subscribe to this channel.